So next topic is how to read Z-score. So as I told you, based on the mean value, we set up as zero, a normal, standard normal curve here. So between 0 and sigma 1, there are many value actually exist on this interval as well. But if we read, maybe we try to read maybe as many data as possible, then it's going to be very complicated. Therefore, we only limited 100 digit score, such as 0.01, 0.02, or 0.11, 0.15, something like that. So beyond between 1 and 2 as well, 1.21, 1.20, 1.35, like that. Okay, negative side also. So Z table also composed. Read until 100 digit here. So look at this Z table, please. So now, when you look at the Z table, then on the left column here, left column, they are all Z score, but it ended 10th digit value, which means the first decimal digit, like a negative 3.4, negative 3.3, or like a 2.0, negative 1.6, like that, right? Then how to read on the 100 digit here? So let's say we want to read Z equal to negative 1.21 here. Okay, then you have to find on the left column, which is negative 1.21 first. Okay, so negative 1.2 first, which is here. And then now, so see, negative 1.2. And then the next one is 1 here, right? So just go to Z table and then you look at 0, 1 right there. Okay? So you found the intercept point. So negative 1.2. So negative 1.2, 1 will be like a point 1131, basically. Okay? There will be 0.1131. Okay, so how about this case? Z equal to maybe 0.65. So now we got the positive Z score, then you also have to go to positive side here. So 0.65, so 0.6 right here, and then go to until 5 section, which means this value, which is 0.7422. Okay. Okay, then now we need to know what those values indicate. We found 0.1131 and 0.7422, but we need to know what their meaning, is, right? So the meaning is cumulative area from the left side until that z-score. Okay, so let me read graph for you. So we have the graph like this. And then that's 0. And center and 0, negative 1.21. It is on left side and then between maybe negative 1 and negative 2. So I can say this is negative 1 and this is negative 2. Then maybe around here. So this is negative 1.21. Okay? Now, after reading the Z score, we got this value, right? Which means basically a cumulative area from left end to until the Z score. Okay, that's area value equal to 0.1131 basically, which means the probability value, cumulative probability value until Z score equal to negative 1.21, that equal to 0.1131. Another word, 11.31% spot. Okay. Now 0.65. 0.65, as you see, it is located on the right side here, right? So it is around maybe 1 and then it's more like one size, so maybe this is 0.65. Okay, therefore, the meaning of this value, is a cumulative area from left hand to here. The total cumulative area value that equal to 0.7422. Good. Which means the percentile value equal to 74.22 like that. Okay? But what if we want to find out the right side? The z-score, I mean the z-table, if you read the z-score, it always gives you left side area value of the z-score. But sometimes we want to find out upper side as well, right? Then can you conjecture how to find the percentage value of on this side? If you guess you subtract this value from the one, that is totally correct because as I told you, this is the probability value, then the sum of total area value must be equal to 1. Therefore, if the left side value equal to 0.722, then the right side will be 1 minus 0.7422, which is 0.2578. Okay? Therefore, if you combine the area value on the left side and the right side, that will be equal to 1. Okay, then, so far so good? I hope so. And then, so next video, we actually want to talk about more z-score value and then also how to convert data x value to z-score value.